This program is brought to you by the Niger Delta Development Commission, NDDC.
This is NDDC Today.
One of the challenges facing most tertiary institutions in the country today is the inadequate provision of hostel accommodations for students. This situation is not any different in the Niger Delta. But the NDDC is about to provide succor to students in one of the higher institutions in the region through the construction of a model hostel. You might want to know which institution is set to benefit from this gesture. Find out in today's episode of the program. This is NDDC Today. I am Adobi Alex Oni. You might have heard of a place called Otueke. Well, if you haven't, Otueke is in Opia local government area of Bayelsa State and home of former President Goodluck Jonathan. Otueke is also home of a federal university which was established some years ago. Like most tertiary institutions in the country, the university has been contending with the problem of student accommodation. Contracts for the construction of a student hostel for the institution was awarded some years back, but did not commence due to project management hiccups. The NDDC recently reactivated the construction of that project at a ceremony held in Otueke. Our reporter was at the ceremony and filed in this report.
As part of its objective to continue the provision of a conducive and habitable hostel accommodation for students of the Niger Delta region, the Niger Delta Development Commission, NDDC, is embarking on the construction of a model hostel accommodation at the Federal University Otueke in Ogbia, local government area of Bayelsa State. The hostel is being built for the school to resolve accommodation problems which the Federal University Otueke has been contending with for some years now. To this effect, the NDDC has held a kickoff meeting with the contractor and the university management with the aim of prompting the contractor to return to site and resume work on the project, which was awarded about 12 years ago but abandoned due to some issues that hindered it from taking off. Engineer Theophilos Alagua is Director, Projects Monitoring and Supervision Department of the NDDC. He highlights the importance of constructing a hostel accommodation for the students of higher institutions in the Niger Delta region.
In fact, we should overemphasize it by not just building one, but to ensure that all students are properly accommodated inside the school so that we can track their activities and bring them up properly in line with them. Not just talking about academics, but also in character.
He also speaks on the agreement guiding the contract signed with the NDDC by the contractor and which will be binding on both parties in the event of an infringement.
We want to let the contractor know that you signed an agreement with us, and under Schedule 1 of the Special Conditions of Contract, after 52 weeks, if you do not deliver on this project, you will be owing us about 193,558 naira per week. Those will be their liquidated and ascertained damages. It's going to take 2 years, that's 104 weeks, for you to complete this project. So if you don't do that, we will be collecting this money every week from you until the project is completed. That is why we are here for this kickoff meeting.
Also speaking, the Director of Physical Planning, Federal University Otueke, Mr. Fidelis Ekenibolo, observed that it is a thing of joy to see the NDDC come back to kickstart the construction of the model hostel in the school, adding that it will help the school to accommodate the students in one place.
For now, we're looking at it that this is another moribund project that is coming that may not see the light of day. But from all what you told us now, it's obvious that NDDC is now serious and NDDC now means business.
The contractor handling the project, engineer Ken Agala, thanked the NDDC for the confidence reposed in him to handle the project and assure that he will mobilize the site immediately to commence work on the project.
As long as there are no issues, we will mobilize to site and start work. And then I thank God that Engineer AB is here. Whatever it is that we meet on the site that can be resolved, we will let you know. But if it is doing the work, it's a project that is very dear to us.
On his part, the project consultant, Mr. Raphael Dangana, requested that the university management should provide an ample land space for the construction of the model hostel.
We need about 20,000 square meters of land space. You know, that is within the boundary. A little extension will be adequate so that when you're doing the external works, you have a working space.
The NDDC has over the years made it a core priority to turn around the fortunes of educational institutions in the Niger Delta through the provision of basic infrastructure. In this regard, apart from the hostel accommodation being built at the University of Otueke, the Commission has built other prototype hostels in universities spread across the region. These include the Imo State University and the Federal University of Technology, both in Owerri, University of Benin, Delta State University, Abraka, Michael Okwara University of Agriculture, Umudike, in Abia State, and University of Uyo Teaching Hospital, and the River State University of Science and Technology.
Seriously, it's something the Nigerian government has really done to make sure that medical program and the University of Uyo medical students are quite comfortable, and for that, I and all other medical students are most grateful.
It's a very beautiful place, actually. I mean, the first day I stepped in here, I was like, wow, is this really our hostel?
I'm so happy to be here because it's specially made for me. I came in here and I made the bed, the wardrobe, the reading table, and also the toilet.
In this hostel, students are really happy here.
In a related development, the Niger Delta Development Commission is constructing a 2-kilometer rigid pavement road in the Niger Delta University, Amasoma, in southern Ijaw local government area of Bayelsa State. The road, which is being built to complement other roads in the institution, will also serve as a link road that will give access to the school through the back entrance. The Director of Projects, Monitoring and Supervision of the NDDC, Engineer Theophilus Alagua, who paid an unscheduled visit to the site, commended the speed at which the contractor has gone about construction work on the road.
We are very happy with the pace of work. We are seeing here the contractor. This unscheduled visit is working even under the rains, and the quality of work that is going on here is highly commendable.
The project engineer, Engineer Austin Edemia, assured that the rainy season will not be a hindrance to the completion of work on the road.
The rain, of course, is not affecting us that much, because the only area it affects us is where we want to cast, at least for that purpose.
A physical planning officer in the school observed that the cooperation between the communities and the contractor has helped to make the work on the road progress smoothly.
We've been having a smooth run with them. No issues at all. Of course, you will only have issues if the contractor is non-compliant. Perhaps it's a kind of contractor that decides to cut corners, but we are not having that kind of scenario here.
From Bayelsa to Edo, and indeed all across the Niger Delta, the NDDC has embarked on roads and other infrastructural projects which have impacted positively on the benefiting communities. Our reporter visited Bayelsa and Edo states recently and came back with this progress report.
Otuan is a riverine community in southern Ijaw local government area of Bayelsa, and its people have been battling with the effects of floods and erosion in their community whenever the adjacent River Niger overflows its banks during the rainy season. During such periods, normal activities in the area close to the river and town are halted or restricted. In view of this scenario, the Niger Delta Development Commission has taken the responsibility to provide a long-term sustainable environmental solution for the people of Otuan by constructing shoreline protection at the River Niger bank adjacent to the community to protect the surrounding of the river from being washed away by flood or erosion.
The scope of work here is we have a total length of 2.7 kilometers that is stretched at the shore. And then what we are doing practically is to utilize geotextile material with a reno mattress, then with a rock, so that it will make it to be difficult for water to climb and come into the community. And the material we are using can last more than 2,000 years, that it can resist rust or whatsoever. It will remain the way it is for the next over 2,000 years.
The construction of the shoreline protection has gone on smoothly and has received the support of the inhabitants of Otuan community, who are happy that such a laudable project has started in their community.
Before, when the rain comes, the erosion, it do eat up the shores, understand? So provided this is done now, I think that would curb it to a certain level. I don't think it will occur again, because this is a job that you can't see anywhere, and it has been done, I know, with time, I believe more will still come.
In Ekeremo local government area of Bayelsa State, the people of Elebiri community are relishing in the solar-powered streetlights installed for them by the Niger Delta Development Commission, which they say has changed the socio-economic lives of the people. The project, which is 100% complete, includes the installation of solar streetlights with solar panels, batteries, LED lamps and sensor controls. In fact, the solar-powered streetlights in Elebiri is one of a kind, laced with unique features. Before the NDDC installed solar-powered streetlights, which lightened up the community, the approach at nightfall in Elebiri was always frightening for the people as a result of insecurity and other negative vices, and this made residents confine themselves to their houses immediately after the sun sets.
We thank God today that NDDC remembered this community, and it's a good thing that today we're happy, and you can attest for yourself, as you came into the town, you saw how the town was lively because of this light. So we give God the glory, and we thank NDDC for a good job. We pray that it should continue with this good gesture so that we can all be happy in this Niger Delta region.
With the provision of solar-powered lights, the entire Elebiri community has been transformed, as people now stay up late into the night, generally having a good time.
In short, we can come out and do anything with the help of this light. We can come out before. We can't come out and play now. Before, everywhere is dark. Once it is night, we both stay indoor. But now, we have the street light. We are very happy. All thanks to the NDDC that brought this light to us.
Traders are also relishing in the provision of the street lights as they display their wares and goods for sale under the illumination of the solar-powered street lights.
This is one of the best lights we have ever seen concerning solar lights. And you can see that the community, even we are in the night hour, you can see that everywhere is still bright. And we are enjoying these lights well.
Bayelsa is also reaping from the drive of the NDDC to link rural communities to major towns and cities in the Niger Delta region, as this development helps open up the rural communities and aids rapid development. Here in Okobiri in Sagbama local government area, the internal road of the community has been reconstructed by the NDDC. and the people are saying it is a new dawn for their community. The socio-economic life of inhabitants of the Ogobiri community has improved tremendously, as they can now move their goods and services right into the community, which in the past was only a mirage.
Well, the entire community appreciated the work NDDC has come to done in our community. We appreciate and we are praying that God should give the leaders of NDDC the fortitude to do more of this to our rural communities.
Access to the community before the NDDC's intervention was difficult, as the whole area was constantly flooded. But now, the intervention of the NDDC has now attracted more people into the community, and this has raised the standard of living in the area. What's more, the construction of this road has brought increased value of land and property in the area. Construction of the Ogobiri Internal Road enjoyed the massive support of the residents, who are now able to commute to their area with ease.
The contractor has extended the road to the Setrako Road. So now vehicles can come to the community through two ways, this way and the other way. So it is free for businessmen and women to transport their goods easily to their own destinations.
The head of the community, while acknowledging the good work done on the road, requested the NDDC to do more for the community. Still on roads, residents of Azikoro Housing Estate in Yenagoa local government area can now finally heave a sigh of relief after the rehabilitation and reconstruction of the internal asphaltic road in the estate, which was carried out by the Niger Delta Development Commission. The estate was conceived and built to accommodate different classes of people and provide them with a good and motorable road network. But the road fell short of that expectation when the initial roads in the estate became deplorable and most sections totally washed away by erosion, leaving residents to wallow in pain and with difficulty of commuting around their estate.
I don't really stay here. I come on visits. Sometimes before it was constructed, so especially when it's raining, you can't even pass here. There was a time I told the security here that they should put canoe so to fly, you know, but now perfect.
Seeing the pain the residents of Azikoro Housing Estate area were consistently passing through, the NDDC came to their rescue and has helped carry out repairs and reconstruction of the over 2.7 kilometer length of internal road.
Now the road is good, is in good shape, because the residents, everybody is happy. They were surprised that such kind of roads were going to come after this long period of bad road, because the road was really bad. There were some spots, that some roads that they even turned to farms because they didn't attend to the roads and the rest of them. So when we came, we just have to do justice to it to make sure the road was done.
A resident, Ebinemi Zitimiola, expressed her gratitude for the good quality of work done on the road by the NDDC and the contractor, and appreciated them also for the pace at which the road was constructed.
The difficulty is there. You don't enjoy the road. You're not happy living in an estate like this, and the road was in that kind of condition. So when the contractor came and started work, we were like, we hope this thing will not stop halfway. We hope they will do a good job. And to our delight, he was so committed to the job. The supervision was there. I keep seeing him anytime I'm going to work, supervising the work, making sure everything is in order.
With the same commitment to assuage the difficulties the people are going through, the NDDC is carrying out reconstruction work on the unmotorable sections of the Zagbagria internal roads in Kulukuma, Opokuma local government area of Bayelsa State. Before this intervention, the community had been plagued with deplorable roads that hampered easy movement of residents. The project is ongoing and is billed to be completed anytime soon. Iwioto is an ancient Bini community in Ipobaoha local government area of Edo State. Situated along the Bini-Sapele-Wori Road, the community is reputed to be as old as the Bini Kingdom itself. Politically, Iwioto is the sixth ward in Ipobaoha local government area with 54 polling units, making her the largest ward in Nigeria. But with all these attributes, the community had for a long time lacked a good and motorable road network. The situation at some time was said to be so bad that many residents had to relocate out of Iwioto community.
This road is impassable before. Many houses have fell down here. Many people are homeless, except we that in the highland over here.
When it rained heavily, no, those of them there don't sleep with their two eyes closed. Sometimes they are woken up with flood water, carrying them with their beds.
Helpless residents who still reside in the community resorted to self-help to manage the flooding of these roads. But to a large extent, this proved ineffective. Thus, the Niger Delta Development Commission, NDDC, intervened and started the construction of the roads with an adequate drainage system. The project was abandoned for some period. But with the decision of the incumbent management of the NDDC to contractors to return to sites to complete abandoned projects, the Iwioto Road has been restarted. As an important community in the entire Benin Kingdom, Iwioto is blessed with a traditional ruler, the Oweha of Iwioto, who is appreciative of the NDDC gesture to turn around the fortunes of his people for good with the construction of the roads that connect the community.
We are grateful to God. We thank God, we thank NDDC for hearing our prayer, for coming to help us. We continue to pray for their leader, pray for the contractor who have come to help us.
Another problem that faced Iwioto community had been the menace of armed robbers and kidnappers who took advantage of the poor condition of the roads in the area.
First Walin is an area where, you know, a den of thieves, kidnappers around, so but it was not accessible. But right now we can access it.
A resident of the community who has been living here for over 45 years attests that the flooding was gradually becoming a thing of the past, with the work on these roads reaching an advanced stage, even as he foresees a growth in business and economic activities upon completion of the construction on the roads.
From my hindsight, I know very well that when these roads are done, you know, stores on Saple Road and major roads are usually very expensive. Many of them will come into the interland, you know, to start business. And I'm sure neighborhood business activities will, you know, will spring up. Because once the roads are good, the next thing is for people to take advantage of it and begin to open stores.
When you people came in now, we are happy. This is a second London to us. We are happy, over happy, over happy.
This place now is nice, so I want to thank the NDDC for their project that they are doing here. This is also Omogun Street. You can see they are working here rapidly. So I thank God for this environment. I thank God for all the things that they have been doing.
The people of Iwioto and other communities there expressing their appreciation to the NDDC for the projects in their community. And just like the feeling of gratitude from these people, their counterparts in Bayelsa State also shared their feeling of appreciation to the NDDC in that report. Moving on, the NDDC has promised to support the Nigerian Institute of Management, NIM, to provide a platform for the sharpening of managerial skills of staff of various organizations in the Niger Delta. The promise was made recently when a delegation from the Nigerian Institute of Management paid a courtesy call on the interim administrator at the corporate headquarters of the commission.
Mr. Effiong Akwa, interim administrator and CEO of NDDC, assured the Nigeria Institute of Management's delegation that the NDDC will contribute to the success of the South-South Summit of the organization slated for August this year. The NDDC boss said that as an interventionist agency, the commission will support the Nigeria Institute of Management in providing the platform for training and improvement of management staff. Akwa observed that the NIM is one of the foremost professional institutions in the country that can be said to have given birth to other professional bodies in the country, and that the contributions of the institute cuts across several sectors in the society. The leader of the NIM delegation and chairman of the River State branch of the body, Mr. Christian Abu, applauded the NDDC interim administrator for bringing stability to the interventionist agency. Mr. Abu remarked that NIM has enjoyed a very robust relationship with the NDDC over the years, and that is why it created a chapter in the commission. He appealed to the NDDC to sponsor members of the NIM to attend important conferences which will help them in enriching their knowledge. The chairman further informed the NDDC boss that the South-South Zone of NIM is organizing a zonal summit in August 2021, which will be attended by over 1,000 professionals. He appealed for support from the NDDC in the area of logistics, particularly in the movement of its members.
We are using this medium to invite you and the management to participate in that program. I can assure you that it will be very well rewarding.
Members of the Nigerian Institute of Management there just joined with the interim administrator of the NDDC. Well, it is on this note that we have come to the end of this week's program. See you same time next week. Good night.